Hey guys, today's video is about proper installation of the Huber Zip System tape. Huber makes a structural wall and roof sheathing panel along with a flashing tape called the Zip Wall System. The panels have a water and air barrier integrated into the surface, leaving the seams of the panels to be sealed up using their tape, meaning that the installation of the tape is crucial for the system to work properly and last. Since the tape is such a critical part of the system, it's important to understand how it works to get the best results. The tape is an acrylic acrylate hybrid adhesive. This isn't grandma's tape. This tape is designed to stick and stay stuck. But what makes a tape actually stick? Now you're probably thinking the adhesive, and you're correct, but not all adhesives are made the same. Adhesives need to be engineered to best suit the material they will adhere to. There is a term when talking about adhesives called wetting out. This means the adhesive flows over the substrate, maximizing the contact area, which increases the attractive forces between the materials, creating a bond. Here's an example. Notice when I put a drop of water on the wood, the water quickly flattens out and spreads across the wood, contacting a large area. If I put the same drop of water on this waterproof membrane, you can see it beads up, reducing the contact area and thus the adhesion. This same effect happens with the tape, and why you can't just use any tape. If it isn't designed for a certain material, it won't adhere properly. This has to do with the surface energy and tension of the materials. But we don't need to go too deep into that. Just know that the total contact area of the adhesive on a micro level is very important. So how does this help you install the tape? Well, the first step is to ensure the seams are wiped clean of any debris. The more debris between the tape and panel, the less contact area for the tape to adhere to. And we already know contact area is important. If your tape has picked up some debris, then you can just cut the affected part off. This brings us to the next step, which is rolling the tape. If you were to look at a tape under a microscope, you would see it's not very even or flat. And if you want the tape to last, you need to get full contact. This is done by rolling the tape. I'm going to say this again because the biggest issue people have is not rolling the tape. Here's an example of not rolling the tape. Okay, that was pretty obvious. But here's another example of not rolling the tape. And here is what it should look like. Using both hands to apply pressure, rolling the entire surface of the tape, and ensuring the ends of the tape are thoroughly pressed in. The ends are common spots that can start to peel up when improperly installed. The ends need the most attention as they can easily collect dust during application and your fingers and oils get on the tape. Rolling presses out the adhesive, allowing better contact. Now that you know the importance of rolling the tape, next is installing the tape and sequence. The tape is best installed in a shingle fashion. That means the tape should overlap the tape below it, just like you would see with roof shingles. You also need to install the tape flat to the panel with no bubbles or creases. Remember, you want full contact to get the best adhesion. Starting with the bottom row of sheathing, you want to tape all the bottom vertical seams first. Before we start, here are two tips. First, make sure your hands are clean. And second, try to touch the least amount of adhesive as possible. The more oil and debris you get on the tape, the less effective it becomes. Start by grabbing the edge of the tape and pull out an appropriate size piece. Then I place my thumbs in the middle of the tape and line them up with the seam. I don't want to press the bottom of the tape against the panel yet. This could cause a bubble or crease to form. Start by applying pressure with your hand to the top of the tape working down while keeping the tape in position. Then I cut the tape with a sharp utility knife. It's important to have a sharp knife so you can make a clean cut for the next piece. Now roll the tape like it's the most important step. Once all the vertical seams are taped on the bottom row, it's time to tape the first horizontal seams. The procedure is the same as the vertical, just horizontal. When you get to an inside or outside corner, leave the tape 1 inch from the edge. This allows the corner tape to adhere to the sheathing. So the sequence goes: bottom vertical seams, then horizontal, then vertical, then horizontal, all the way up the wall. Next is inside and outside corners. There is definitely some tips and tricks to getting a perfect bubble and crease-free corner. But this will be its own separate video because it's an important detail. And it makes you come back to the channel, giving you another chance to hit that subscribe button. The next area is the roof, which is basically the same as the walls with a couple exceptions. One method I like to use that works really good is to use the zip sheathing as a subfascia. This allows me to tape the subfascia to the roof, waterproofing this intersection. Then using spacers or a drainage mat to provide an air gap behind the fascia. After many years of doing home repairs, I commonly found the roof sheathing edge, fascia board, and rafter tails to have significant rot damage, and it was always a costly fix. This method eliminates those issues and makes for a great, durable assembly. Here is the sequence. The roof and subfascia intersection get taped first, then the vertical seams overlapping the subfascia tape, next the horizontal seams, then the vertical seams, all the way up the roof, then the gable ends, and last, the ridge. With this system and method, you can create a water and airtight assembly. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for the corner tape install video. Hit those like and subscribe buttons. Check out my other videos before you go, and I'll see you next time. We'll